one of the heroic figures of our time, Cesar Chavez.
So you didn't really know a lot about this story, and I believe what your father has, he actually was an immigrant.
Yeah.
And he was really touched that you got this role.
Yeah, he was. I'm like, he's a tough Mexican dude. So when I told him, you know, that I got the part of Cesar Chavez, he just, you know, paused for 5 seconds, and then he's like, "It's good, Mike. I'll talk to you later, buddy." And then he just went off. But yeah, I didn't know, and that's why I liked doing this movie in the beginning, because there was so much more that I didn't know, like the things that he had to sacrifice. And you think that, like, almost like a politician, like, they want to be in a position of power and stuff. He didn't want anything. He didn't even want the attention that really it came with. But he's like, you know, if this is what it's going to do, then this is what's going to happen. You know, he was kind of nervous when he gave these speeches. Mm. And you know, it was tough. You know, he was like, he had his own kind of charisma, but he wasn't like a Martin Luther King in speech. And you know, we wanted to like kind of do that.
I have a strong connection with this film because I think stories like this need to be out. You know, stories that show us that that change can come from us. You know, that you don't have to have special powers and be a hero, and ordinary people can do extraordinary things, you know. Yeah, and they showed us that. I wouldn't do a film about a movement like this, and the first film about Cesar Chavez, without the blessing of the family and the support of them also, because I wanted to do a film about everything that is not written in books, that is not in the documentaries, that you know, that personal and intimate stories and colors that I like seeing in film.
Cesar Chavez and the movement that he led was a big part of my education. I grew up in California, and you know, it's ingrained in the history here, and I just assumed that everybody knew who Cesar Chavez was, and to my surprise, that's not the case. There's a lot of Americans who don't know who Cesar was, so I'm very glad to have been a part of a film that might make more people aware of what he stood for and what he fought for, and the progress and the gains he was able to make fighting for social justice.
Mrs. Chavez, we have a court
huelga!
Order that forbids you from saying the word huelga.
Huelga! Huelga!
This is your first warning, Mrs. Chavez.
Huelga! I didn't know Helen Chavez or what role she played in the movement. And, you know, Diego enlightened me a bit, but also through our research and through talking to her family and also getting to spend some time with her, it became very clear that this was an incredibly able and capable and active woman in both the cause and the movement, and being a partner to Cesar as she was, you know, raising her family and protecting her children. So.